Today, I would like to talk about fixing your progesterone. I talk about this in chapter 11 of the book on fixing your sex hormones. And so, progesterone is a hormone that's produced by the ovaries and then later by the adrenal glands. And it's a precursor for so many hormones. Believe it or not, our sex hormones and a lot of our adrenal stress hormones come from the production of cholesterol. That's right, you heard it, folks. Cholesterol, so fats. And then cholesterol goes into pregnenolone and progesterone. And then there's a cascade that happens where resources will go off to make sex hormones and then will go off to make adrenal hormones. And just as an aside, this is the reason why when you're stressed and your adrenals aren't working right, that you do not have a libido, because your resources are all going to be shunted towards survival and towards making sure that your adrenals are functioning right, and they're not going towards the sex hormones. And consequently, a lot of times people also have sex hormone deficiencies like we're talking about. So that's where the progesterone is made. That's kind of a little bit what the cascade looks like. Symptoms of progesterone deficiency are hard time falling asleep, and this is for menopausal women most of the time, hard time falling asleep, anxiety, depression. Oftentimes it's considered the cuddle hormone. You can also get migraines, headaches, because it's a wonderful vasodilator. You can get constipation as well, because it dilates smooth muscle, which is found in blood vessels as well as in the intestines, and so there can be some consequences there. And then also premenstrual symptoms. So before the age of menopause, we talked a little bit last time about that ratio of not having enough progesterone and having too much estrogen in that week before your period during what's called PMDD, premenstrual dysphoric disorder, or PMS. So that's a little bit about the symptoms of progesterone. And so the way that you use progesterone in treatment, you can either consume more fats. You know, like I said, it comes from cholesterol. You can take some bioidentical progesterone. You can use some maca, like we talked about, that Feminescence Pro product that I really like. That's a maca grown specifically for increasing estrogen and progesterone. So that can be very helpful. And when you take bioidentical progesterone, you can actually take it orally in addition to cream, which is not something that you can do with estrogen. With estrogens, if you take it orally, it gets changed in the liver, and it can become carcinogenic, or it can become cancer-causing. But with the progesterone, you can take it orally because it is fat-soluble. It is not water-soluble, which means it's not processed by the liver, which means it's not going to change as it's processed through the body. And I find that a lot of times taking it orally is actually better for the reasons that I use it, which is oftentimes for anxiety and sleep. So it just seems like the oral form works better. And what I have people do is I'll have them start at a low dose and ramp up slowly. This is, as you can see, a pattern with me. Start low, go slow, and ramp up. And so I'll have people start with like 25 milligram capsules of the progesterone, increase every 3 days or so by a capsule until they get up to the appropriate dose. If they're groggy the next morning, it means they've taken too much. And we basically are looking for the ability to sleep through the night, and you'll also improve good quality sleep. So super important, incredibly helpful for those women going through menopause, and also for changing that ratio between progesterone and estrogen. So any symptom of estrogen excess, like we talked about last time, can also be remedied by taking more progesterone in addition to lowering the estrogen. So we talked about symptoms. Oh, testing. We talked about symptoms. We talked about treatment. So testing, you can do salivary testing, so saliva testing, spitting into a little tube, but that doesn't work if you're already on progesterone. So if you're already on progesterone, you're going to want to use urine hormone testing. And I talk about this all in my book. So if you're interested in learning more, check out my book on Amazon. Mm-hmm. Hope you have a wonderful day. Thanks for watching.